In this video, we're going to go over how to add and subtract time using Excel. And to illustrate this, we're going to look at two examples. One, we're going to create a makeshift meeting agenda, and then the other one, we're going to calculate the number of hours worked in a day. So the first thing we want to do is make sure our cells are formatted correctly. So we're going to be entering our time in column B, which I have highlighted here. So after you highlight it, right-click. Under Format Cells, we want to, under Category, select Time. And there's several options for time formatting. I'm going to choose the one that says PM. I think for the agenda especially, that'll make it visually easier for the guests to know when their different sessions will be happening. So we have the first one will be our welcome reception, and we want that to start at 8 a.m. And we want to give guests a half an hour to say hello to other guests, get seated, get settled, etc. And then we want the opening statements to start at 8:30. So the formula will be equals cell B3, where we just typed 8 a.m., plus the time function. And the time function, you see here that it's made up of hour, minute, and second. So we need 30 minutes to have them be seated. So we're going to type 0 for the hour, 30 for the minutes, and 0 for the second, and then close our parentheses. And so now we have the opening statements beginning at 8:30. Now the opening statements will also last a half an hour, so same exact formula. And we have our first speaker beginning at 9 a.m. Now let's say the first speaker will be speaking for 45 minutes. You would go through the same exercise and say equals the cell above it, 9 a.m. plus time, and this time it'll be 45 minutes. And so speaker one will go from 9 a.m. to 9:45, at which time the break will start. And what's good about this is if you have an agenda where you have speakers still working on their presentations and may not necessarily know how long they'll speak, as you make adjustments, you'll see everything auto-adjust so you don't end up with errors in your agenda later. You can quickly see where you need to make adjustments and tweaks as you go. So our next example, we want to figure out the number of hours worked. So let's say we start at work at 8 a.m. And another thing before we go on, you'll notice that as I do this, I'm still typing 8:00 a.m. because if I just simply type 8, it gives you something weird. It thinks it's 12 a.m. So that's not what we want. So we're going to just stick with typing 8 o'clock, and it will know that it's a.m. So work ended at 4:45 p.m. So likewise, you can choose two ways to enter that. You can do it in military time and say you worked until 16:45, which is 4:45, or you could type 4:45, but then you have to make sure to type p.m. after so that the function doesn't think you started at 4, or you ended at 4:45 in the morning. So, okay, number of hours worked. So here we're going to subtract. And what we're going to get back is going to be a little bit of a different number. It's not going to be an a.m. or p.m. So we're going to just say equals 4:45 when work ended minus 8 a.m. when it started. And so it says 8:45. Now, this is not right. This has to do with the formatting, not the formula. So with your highlighting, with your cursor on that cell, you're going to right-click and go back into your format cells. And this time we're going to choose the format right above it that simply has the hours and minutes. So we click on that, and now we have the correct answer. The full day was 8 hours and 45 minutes of hours worked. So I hope this exercise was helpful, or these exercises were helpful for you. Definitely a lot of practical applications for adding and subtracting time. If you enjoyed this video, please do make sure to subscribe and like. And if you subscribe, obviously you'll be getting notifications of my new videos right as they come out. So hope you become a subscriber. Thank you for watching.